Hello, Dissenters. My name is Italix, and I am here today with a game currently in development on the PC called Shelter, a game that has recently been greenlit by the community. It's a game all about taking care of your children, in this case, animal children. You take on the role of a mother badger, and you have some cubs that you have to look after, make sure they stay fed, and of course, as the name would suggest, sheltered. So let's go ahead and jump into a new game and see what it's all about. Here we are in the game world, taking on our role as mother badger, taking care of these small little cubs. And it would seem we've got four scampering along behind us right now, and one that appears to be sleeping? Or it's a different color, so perhaps it's sick as well. And I think we can do a couple things here. We can probably pick things up with left click, and we can move a little bit slower, maybe just sneak with control and get everyone to be a little bit more quiet. And we're in this little tunnel, these little caverns here, and we've probably got to help our little sickling here figure out how to get better. So we probably want to take a look around and see if we can find anything. If there's some kind of vegetable right here with a little stem coming out of it, I can pick that up, put it in my mouth, and take it to nurse my sweet Jamie back to health. Why Jamie? I don't know. That was just the first name I thought of. Take a little bite of that. Hope you feel better. Oh, he does feel better. Hear that little musical cue? All right, so we've got everyone back up to speed here, and we're going to be able to take them out into the wild. Hopefully, maybe find a new place to get some food, but it will be on Steam when it does release. And I'll just go ahead and put a link in the description of this video so you guys, if you want to get more information, maybe watch a trailer for this game, see what else it might store for you in the future, you can do so at the link in the description of this video. If you enjoy this video and you want to see more like it, more indie game spotlights, the games you may not have even known existed, let me know by leaving me a like and a comment below. I would appreciate it very much. I believe we're about to exit our little tunnel here with our lovely cublings. Our cublings. That's not a word, but it's a word now. And here we are in the outside world. You'll notice this game has a very distinct art style. Everything is very hard cut from one another, like the textures don't really blend in very well. And that's very intentional. It has a very distinct, almost Japanese style art style to it. Lots of floating blades of grass and hand-painted textures. It all looks very nice, very unique style. Definitely like it. All right, so obviously we're going to want to feed our little kids some more so we can pick up another one of these little plants out of the ground. And of course, exploration is going to be what is... Okay, you guys really just want to dance, don't you? You guys just want to dance. Who am I supposed to... How am I supposed to choose who to give this to? I think this, you look the most sickly. I'm gonna give this to you. You get to feast on it. You guys can share it if you want to. You know, there's enough food there for everyone. Apparently not, though. But yes, exploration is going to be a huge facet of this game. Just going throughout the game world, kind of peaceably looking around, seeing what you can find. We have a little prompt to tell us how to do something in this game, a new gameplay mechanic that we're going to be learning as we go. Some of these trees are going to have some resources for us to help take care of our cubs here. We can hit the tree by shift, holding shift and running into it. We'll get a little bit of a ram going on right there. One of our cubs got the apple that fell from the tree. So now we're going to be able to sprint, which is nice. Be able to run a little bit faster, maybe get away from some danger. I just really love the way this game looks. It's so peaceful. All right, we've got our apples from our trees. We're just going to walk gingerly in this direction, keeping an eye out for predators and possible other evil. There's not going to be any people in this game, by the way. There's not going to be no humans. So you're going to be alone in the animal kingdom, and that's the feeling that Might and Delight is really going for, to make you feel attached to your little family here. And to just try to imagine what it might feel like to have this litter of cubs and have to make sure they're all still there, you know, checking behind you every so often, make sure they didn't get lost or separated or anything like that. Continue to look out for supplies and resources and safe places to hide. So I'm sure there's going to be some kind of hide-and-seek mechanics here where you have to... Okay, we're going to pick up one of these. Can we pick up one of these? All right, let's pick up one. Because they're going to grab one by themselves. I'm not sure who we should give this to. So perhaps I should just let them continue. Will they continue to follow me, or are they just going to stand and dance there until I drop this? Okay, I'll put the apple down. First come, first serve. Not just kidding. I'm going to pick it up. All right. Which one of you cute little badger cubs is going to get this food? I gave it to the middle one last time. So we're going to give it to this one on the right over here. Hopefully he hasn't eaten too much already. I'm going to try to remember which ones I've already given food to make sure none of them starve and die. Making our way to these rocks, this cliff face over here. There's a waterfall. Perhaps something might be hiding behind it. There's a little cavern over here to the right. I don't see any more trees with any more food on them. to feed. I'm not sure also how we're going to be able to tell which of our cubs needs food. Perhaps we just have to pay attention to which one we've fed before. Can we cross water? I'm guessing we can't, because little cubs probably can't swim. So we're just going to run into the cavern over here and see where it takes us. We're going to have to do some hunting. We got a little ripping frog over here. So we're just going to sprint at him and then try to catch him. So yeah, we got to catch the frog. All right, I'm going to jump on the frog. Now I've got a dead frog, and we got to figure out who we're going to feed this to. All right, kiddos. I've already fed it to the middle right, the middle left. So we're going to go far right. There you go. There you go, little one. You guys, if you want to name these cubs in the comments below, I'm probably not going to do a series on this, but I'm just curious. What should their names be? It's time to go hunting again, this time for really brave mice. This mouse is not scared of Mama Badger and her cubs, so we must punish him for his insolence by snatching him up in our jaw and deciding who to feed. I believe, let's see, get a raid, my children. I've trained you well, except for you on the left there, going in circles. He was always the dumb one. We were never really certain when he was born if he would turn out normal like the rest of you. But you know, we love him anyways, despite the fact he has no idea what's going on right now. All right, we'll drop this one for you over here on the right. And we should have a little bit more food around here soon. Hopefully for you guys, I don't want you to starve or anything like that. Yes, a little apple. And we're just going to keep feeding, guys. And Oh, Johnny, you're just really like gung-ho, right? You weren't even going to give a chance for your brothers to get fed. I don't even remember which one you are. So if you guys want to play it really smart, you can just look at the coats, try to memorize which one's which, and figure out if they're the ones that have been feeding by the way they look. Hopefully none of you fall off the edge here. That would be pretty detrimental to your health. So let's walk away from the edge, all right? Let's walk through this little thick grass here that's kind of slowing us down. Probably it's going to be used in the future as kind of a stealth mechanic. And here, once again, is the waterfall. Looks really nice. We're almost at the top of the cliff where it's coming from and originating. That's a really high river up there, or maybe we were just in a valley before. Oh, look, a very dangerous, precarious position tree. Leaning over the edge at any point could fall over and rip away one of my children. All right, you guys here? You guys all here? Oh! Oh! There's the first predator, I think, guys. Flying overhead, casting a shadow on the whole area with a giant pink tree. This place looks really cool. All right, so we're gonna wanna watch out for that, of course, not get picked off by this bird of prey here who seems to be flying around over here. You see nothing, bird? All right, let's go, guys. Let's go. Quick. Get in. No, not my babies. Don't take the babies. He can't see us if we hide in the tall grass. All right, we're gonna make it from the grass over to this wood log. All right, go ahead, bird. Go ahead, you see nothing. All right, go, babies. Go. Run, babies. Into the log. Yes. Oh, it's shaking the log now. I'm really scared, guys. I'm really scared. Okay, let's keep an eye out. Let's make sure. Oh, there goes the shadow. Now's the time. Oh, no. Did I do it wrong? No, I didn't do it. Oh, yeah, battle. Oh, did he get one? Are you guys still here? Shh, wait for it to pass. Right away it goes. Here we go. Crossing the street before the bird can get to us. Yeah, there we go. All right, now we're making our progress up here. We're almost there. We're almost there, guys. I don't know what we're going to do when we get there, but it looks like it's really important. So, let's go. We're there. All right, watch for the babies. Hopefully they're all still behind me. I honestly have no idea. I'm assuming that all five are still here. All right, is the bird going to go away now? Can we make it to this tree? I don't see the shadow. Do you guys see the shadow? Where is it? I think we can go? Let's go. We're going. Oh no. This looks really dangerous. No! I lost one! Did you see him run off the side? Why? Why? You killed all of us. Okay, no, we're actually still alive somehow. By a miracle, all of us survived that huge fall. We were knocked unconscious until the nighttime. And now it is nighttime. This game is really cool art style. It definitely just looks aesthetically great. I have no idea where the game's gonna go from here, but you can see some of the mechanics developing already. And here we have a new one. What was that? That was a terrifying noise. All right, we've only got four of our babies right now. Where's the fifth one? He's around here somewhere. All right, so I heard that creepy noise and one of my cubs is missing. I'm not sure if something like just came and snatched it from me or if I lost it. I have no idea, but look, I've only got four right now, and I have to be really slow at the nighttime because if they go outside that light radius, they forget where I am, and I have to go back and find them. So this game is basically one huge escort quest. That could be good or bad. It could be good because it kind of gives you a sense of needing to take care of these guys. Like, you can see that I've already lost one and I feel terrible about it, but I'm just going to continue on for the purpose of this video because I have no idea. I have no idea what happened. So you're still going to have to do some searching for food, but you're also going to have to make sure that they stay along with you the whole way. So we've got a couple more apples dropping here. All right, guys, got to stay here and watch you while you eat just to make sure that you can still find me and see me. But yeah, nighttime is going to add a whole different dynamic to things. It's a lot harder to see unless you get really close to something. And one of my babies is dead. And you've also got to worry about chasing these critters down, like this frog, for example. Not knowing if, you have to chase it, and whoops, you just lost all your cups. All right, I'm going to feed that to you, and let's go ahead and progress. Anyways, guys, I just wanted to give you a quick look at Shelter. I'm not going to do too much more than this. Just wanted to show you some of the basic gameplay mechanics. Let you know that this game has been greenlit. It will be available on Steam pretty soon, I'd be guessing. It does seem to be in a very nicely polished state right now. Hopefully, some more gameplay add-ons, additions, in that I don't really necessarily want the only gameplay mechanic to primarily be knocking over fruit and picking it up and feeding my cups. Hopefully it goes a little bit deeper than that the further you progress, but again, this is only like two levels in, so we'll see in the future what it holds, and hopefully it's going to be something very compelling, something very unique, something very different from everything else that's currently out there right now. Thank you guys very much for watching this video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, let me know. My name is Italics, and I will see you next time.